What are you doing here? Sarah?
Yeah.
Are we about to collab?
Hi, I'm Sarah Renae Clark, and today I'm heading to Jazza Studios for my first ever art collaboration. And who better to work with than one of the most loved art YouTubers in the world, Jazza.
You went out of the lines already.
Shh.
If you haven't met Jazza, he's crazy creative, willing to take on any challenge, and is one of the nicest people you'll come across on YouTube. I've been subscribed to him for years, and I'll link to his channel in the description below so you can go subscribe too. He has over 1,200 videos, over a billion views, and 5.69 million subscribers. So I've got some catching up to do. As you can imagine, having the opportunity to work with Jazza on one of his videos is incredibly exciting. So I didn't want to come empty-handed. I decided to create a special tribute to Jazza's new beard in honor of his fans and the hundreds of comments about how much it makes him look like Thor. So the only appropriate tribute from an art channel is a piece of art.
What?
I wanted to put my best effort into this picture, so that means using my best supplies. I have just purchased a brand new set of Caran Luminance and Caran Pablo pencils. I've never used the Pablos until today, but these are some of the best pencils in the world. I also bought a much bigger range of the Distress Oxide inks from Ranger Inks because I loved using these in my previous backgrounds video and I've been wanting to try them again. So we'll see how they go today. I want this drawing to be as realistic as possible, so I'm tracing my reference image instead of drawing it freehand. I haven't had much experience drawing people, so I don't want incorrect proportions or little inconsistencies to ruin my final result. I've found a picture of Thor from one of the Marvel movie posters, but I've done a little bit of photoshopping to include Jazza in our image, which you'll see as our picture comes together. I want to start on the background, so I'll mask off my character with some masking film like I showed you the last time I used these. Although, where have I put it? These drawers are really organized, but I have no idea where this masking film is. I wonder if this will work. Okay, the Cricut transfer tape kind of works, but it's much thicker, so it's not cutting as easily. In hindsight, I could have actually cut this with my Cricut Maker, or probably should have just used some washi tape to mask this off, but I'm committed now. The washi will be perfect though to mask the straight lines in our background. So the Distress Oxides worked fantastically for the background, except I forgot to press record on the camera. Sorry. Otherwise, this worked quite well. Despite my tech failings, the background is working well, and I've pulled out my Caran pastel pencils to add some extra colors that I didn't quite have with the Distress Oxide ink pads and to make some extra touch-ups. I'm not sure how well the pastel will last on this particular paper, so I will seal this layer with some workable fixative before removing my masking and moving on to my colored pencil work on top. Now for the face. And no, this is not Chris Hemsworth, this is Jazza. Well, I hope it looks like Jazza. That's the plan. The Luminance and Pablo pencils are really nice to work with together, especially the Pablo pencils for these tiny details on the face. This probably would have been much easier to draw if it wasn't so small, because at this scale, a tiny mistake makes a huge difference to the overall look. I think this is actually the first time I've drawn a face with colored pencils, so the pressure is really on. I like it, but I'm not 100% sure this looks like Jazza, so I might come back to this with fresh eyes later. This picture has some very interesting lighting and a lot of contrast, so it looks very yellow when I'm colouring the arm without the context of the rest of the picture yet. At this stage, I just have to trust the process. Speaking of trusting the process, putting my trust in Jazza for the day was an interesting experience. We arrived on set with very little idea of what to expect, but I came ready for anything.
We'll see how you
do. I feel like I'm prepared, as long as I didn't need to bring a change of clothes.
You didn't?
I actually did.
Did you? Okay. There's a spaghetti segment coming up, so.
It's too easy, Sarah.
I should have known that collabing with Jazza would mean something like this.
You need to feel the pain of being on the Jazza channel, because we don't do art the normal way here. We do it in a needlessly convoluted, ambitious and stupid way.
Complicated.
But it's fun.
Jazza has taken on some pretty epic challenges in the past. He's known by many for his illustration and animation skills, but his art challenges are some of my favourite on YouTube. He's tried sculpting with noodles, foam and chocolate. He's taken on robots and he's painted with Skittles. And if that's not enough reasons to subscribe, there's this.
Hello, I am Bob the Grey. Welcome to the joy of painting in Middle Earth.
So in a way, Jazza is a superhero of the art world on YouTube. Too far? Back to our drawing. For the cape, I've decided to use a black pro marker as a base layer. This will allow me to start from the dark and build my layers from dark to light instead of the other way around, which is something that's harder to do if I'm only using pencils. There is a lot happening at the bottom of this picture, so I don't have a clear plan yet as to how I'll pull this whole look off, but I'm starting with some black dots. I think we could work in layers and build this up, but we'll come back to this later. Just trust me on this, we'll be fine. This picture isn't the only thing I prepared for Jazza. I wanted to make sure our collab was as memorable as possible. So I've loaded up another surprise inside this briefcase that he did not see coming.
It's got dry ice? What is this? If you approach me on the street with this, I'll be very scared, but I love your dramatic flair. Can we just, how did you do the, amazing.
But you'll have to go watch Jazza's video over on his channel to see the full reveal of that one. This is where quality pencils makes a big difference too. Good quality pencils like these will work really well in a darker background and allow me to build up a lot of color so I can approach this more confidently. I'm really enjoying these pencils, although I'm concentrating so hard that I've been holding the pencils really tightly and with a bad grip that isn't ideal for long periods of drawing. It's my go-to grip when I get in the zone, but I'm trying to break the habit because it does make my hands sore after a while, even with quality pencils like these. For the sword, I'm embracing the pencil texture. I love the inclusion of blue, teal, and green in this part of the picture to balance out the warmth of everything else. I've used a white pencil with hard pressure to create these small highlights along the black ridges, which really adds to the realistic look as well. The bottom of the sword disappears into our foreground at the bottom here, so I'm just building it into a red at the moment. Sorry, this isn't supposed to be the bloody edge that it currently looks like, it's just the background. I mean, the foreground. This bottom bit. Speaking of which, let's see what we can do to bring this area to life. I've already got some red and black here from the background layer and the black marker, so I'm going to start by adding a layer of pencil to create a cloudiness over the whole area, blocking out more areas between these reds and blacks. These black dots underneath will help to create a bit of depth, but I want to mostly cover them up at this point. Those yellow spots I've just done will stand out as well, because I've used extra pressure so they will indent the paper and shouldn't really allow much extra pencil over the top, hopefully making them stand out a little bit through the fog. I still don't have a full plan of how this part will look, but I'm feeling more confident as I work my way through it, and I'm going to finish it off with some red, black, and white paint pens to create a top layer of particles that should hopefully finish off this whole effect. I'm blending a few with my fingers to make them blurry and leaving others crisp. And I'm kind of surprised, but really happy with how this is turning out. I've been thinking about what to include on Jazz's belt buckle, since it felt like a good opportunity to include something symbolic of his channel. But it's also a very small area to draw on, so Shane suggested a simple YouTube play button. I wonder how long it will take Jazza to notice this when we finally give it to him at his studio soon. I seriously can't wait to see his reaction. He's invited us to his studio, but he has no idea that I'm preparing anything for him, let alone drawing a portrait of him as the God of Thunder. If you've come over from Jazza's channel, please let me know in the comments now what you think his reaction is going to be. And we'll find out in a few moments. I'm going to put a little more work into his face because I think he's smiling a bit too much and needs a few more shadows to match the rest of the picture. Hopefully, I haven't layered too much already that I can still make some adjustments here. Actually, I do think that's better now, and so we're almost done. The lighting and colours of this shoulder really finish this piece off. It brings such a nice balance of colour. Or maybe it's just because I like teal. But after some final touch-ups and highlights with my white gel pen, I'm really happy with how this has turned out. I really hope Jazza likes this. It'll be really awkward if he doesn't like the whole Thor joke though. It's time to head back to the studio to find out. So we're here in Jazza's studio and I did want to come with some special gifts as a bit of a thank you because this is okay. My first collab, but also just because it's a little bit of a, I guess,
thank you for coming.
Studio warming so nice as well. Now with the first gift, I did want to think, so what kind of gift would Jazza give someone in a collab?
You've been mischievous, haven't you?
A little bit on behalf of our friend ADC Art Attack, I got you a coffee cup.
Of course, yep, good. Always need to stock up my rubbish supplies.
The second gift is actually more for your team. I know that a creative person like yourself can sometimes get a bit over ambitious with ideas. So
yes.
I think sometimes the team might need a no button.
I love it.
So Rob, would Rob's you like to?
No. No, this is not for you. You have no idea how much I throw at him. I can't.
So Rob, yeah.
No, it's not for you, Rob. You're not allowed it. So, Gareth can have it. I think we need one of those for every room.
All right, now the other thing I realised is that this isn't technically our first collab because I made a TikTok video a while ago. And you've done a video about TikTok videos.
Let's give this a crack. Here's my Frankenstein too short pencil. And this feels pretty great. That's actually a really good art hack.
That was you?
It works.
It works really well.
This is the original.
We still have mine somewhere. That's so funny. I can't believe that was you.
I actually did buy you a real one as well.
Okay.
The last gift I have is a little bit of a tribute on behalf of your fans, I guess, because everyone is loving the beard. So we had to make sure that Rob's losing it over
Rob's
in the corner.
Rob's trying to pick me every day. He's like representing.
I'm the biggest beard fan. What is that?
The only Thor toy that I could find is clean shaven.
Gujitsu. It's lightning. He's got the power of lightning. Thank you so much.
Look, there is actually one more thing.
There is.
That we did. What? In tribute to Thor.
What? That's so cool.
So I have drawn this over the last few days.
I'm showing you, but I really want to look at it. This is incredible. You've seen it. You've just watched it.
So wow. This is Jazza as Thor. That? In every video that I've watched in the last few weeks, I think probably 50% of the comments are about the new beard.
If I, I'm going to be honest with you. You guys get the scoop here. It was strategic. It was a strategic beard. I want you to talk about it. I'll give you something to talk about.
It's
invested in my beard than
the rest of your channel.
Well, if I ever shave,
this will be forever.
I will have this to cherish this very strange period of time. This is amazing. Thank you so much. This is so well done too, and so lifelike.
It's actually the first time.
Which is great.
It's actually the first time I've drawn a person with coloured pencils.
That's so cool. You've done an amazing job. The lighting on like the shoulder armour and the skin is so cool. I love it. Thank you so much, Sarah. I really appreciate it. And thank you for having me on your channel and spending the time to make this. That is so cool. If you've come over here from my channel, subscribe to Sarah because she makes incredible stuff. And it's awesome to see like how creative and fast like you've adapted to YouTube, like, because you haven't been doing YouTube videos for very long, but you guys work your guts out and do really cool stuff. So yeah, thanks for coming here and being a part of this with me.
Thank you.
This is awesome. I feel like we should film in this new home.
I also walked away with a special gift from Jazza, one of his new Pro Artist Series boxes that I've left unopened so that you can take a first look inside with me in my next video. So make sure you're subscribed and turn on your notifications so that you don't miss that exciting unboxing. Thank you so much guys for watching this video, and please check out the full video of the coloring that I did with Jazza over on his channel. Epic. I will link to that right here for you so that you can check it out now. It was a lot of fun. Thank really you cool. so much for having me.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for coming over. I really appreciate not only your awesome content, but also how involved you are in the community. And it's just been really fun to work with a local yes. artist smashing it on YouTube in the art community.
Sorry, oh, yeah. This will definitely, I think, be the first of many collabs. I'm saying it now. But definitely go check out Jazza's channel. He is amazing.
Thank you so
One
much.
Of the best art YouTube channels on YouTube, so go check that out now and stick around for some more awesome content on here as well.